is David Guetta.
This is your boy Fetty Wap.
This is Sia.
Showet på The Voice med Jakob Morup.
Thank you so much. Happy to speak to you.
How are you?
I'm great. It's a sunny day here in London, so this is kind of a miracle. You know, every time the sun is out in London, it's happiness everywhere.
Yeah, it's the same here in Denmark. If we have one sunny day, we are happy.
I'm sure.
Your new single, the single Bang My Head, that we are playing a lot here on The Voice, is with Fetty Wap and Sia. Is it difficult for you to choose who you will collab with on new tracks?
What's difficult is really try to reinvent myself, and I think this record is so exciting because it's the most unexpected collaboration, you know, because Sia is probably the best in indie pop. Fetty Wap is number one in the US for urban music, and I'm electronic. So to put all of these different worlds together, it makes the record really unique, I think. And I'm really, really happy about this.
I heard that you needed to make some changes in the drop to make it right. Is that right?
Oh, I made around 100 different versions of
okay,
this record.
Yeah.
You have no idea.
Was it difficult?
Very difficult.
David, do you feel there is a public pressure on you from your dedicated fans and labels to always make the next big hit, or is it just yourself trying pushing it up to the next level?
Yeah, it's more a pressure that I put on myself. And you know, the thing is, it's also, you're right, in a way, the expectation of people, because sometimes we speak about this with other DJ producers, and I say, you're so lucky because, you know, if you make a record that makes a top 10, for you, it's a very big success. But if I make a top 10, for me, it's a flop. So it's like, it's very hard to take more risk, you know, because when you begin, you can take all the risk you want because nobody expects you to be successful. And this is why I also keep on making some DJ records sometimes, you know, because it's very important for me to be able to express myself and just have fun without the pressure of a record being a hit. And on my repack, because we made it's called Listen Again, it's a new version of the album with Bang My Head, but also some club beats that I made for myself when I'm DJing, and I put here. You know, and I need this. I love making those huge radio records, but I also, you know, it's also important for me sometimes to do like records that are a little more experimental and purely electronic, for example.
But David, do you sometimes miss the way you were working daily and produced your music in the beginning of your career?
You know, to be honest, I didn't change so much the way I'm working.
Okay.
And you know, really, I still work with the same, like working on my laptop, all of this, you know, this is not so different. What is different is when I write songs, you know, now I can afford to take a big studio and, you know, make demo with amazing singers, and yes, that's different. But when it comes to making beats, it's not so different.
When you are around the world and walking down red carpets, visiting radio stations, talking with reporters, speaking with me on the phone and other curious people, is there a question you fear to be asked?
No, I'm not afraid of any type of question.
Okay, is there a question you always get?
Yeah, of course. Very often the same type of questions come, you know, but it's more like, okay, what's your dream collaboration? This type of questions.
Yeah.
But they don't make me afraid. They can make me bored at the max.
I understand that. I hope these questions are a little bit different from the others. I know that you are a hard worker and a busy man. Is there any time of year where you can calm down and take a rest?
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, the time is coming. It's Christmas time. And then I'm a completely normal person. I go visit my family in Paris. I see my old friends, and yes, it's just like a nice time with people I love.
When you are traveling around the globe and then coming back to your homeland, France, I know that you not live in France anymore, but maybe there is something that you look really, really forward to.
Yeah, I live between London, Ibiza, Dubai, and Los Angeles. I live in a plane, basically, you know. But yes, every time I go back to Paris, it feels special because,
you know,
this is where I was born and I was raised.
Okay, David Guetta, I know that you and the Danish DJ Morten is very good friends.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
I have seen that on Boom Boom Breach's Snapchat.
yeah.
It reveals everything, you know that? Are you guys hanging out a lot?
Yeah, we were staying at my house in the summer, and yeah, we're friends.
But David, I think that you meet so many new people all the time. Is it difficult to start up and get new friendships?
Well, I'm a very open-minded person, so, you know, I'm always open to life and discover new people and have new experiences. So it's just that I'm busy, and as you said, you know, it's a little bit difficult because I'm very often away, you know. So, of course, it's complicated to... have a relationship, already, you know, I have my family and I don't see them much. So yes, that's a little tricky when it comes to personal life. It's a little bit of a sacrifice to get to that point, really.
Now we know that Morten has lived in your house for the summer on Ibiza. I have a different kind of question for you. Morten has a huge Mickey Mouse tattoo on his back. Do you think it's cool? And I know you have seen it because I saw the Snapchat.
Yeah, I think Morten, I love his look. Also his personality. The combination of... a little rough and also a very sweet person. I like this.
We all know that you are born and raised in France, the country with Disneyland. If you should have a cartoon figure on your body, which one?
I don't have any tattoo. The thing is, I am very extreme in everything I do. So it's no tattoo at all, or probably exactly like Morten, like doing it everywhere. You know, I don't like just a small one.
You cannot say that you don't want to. If you should have one.
I don't know. I guess if I knew, I would have done it.
Okay. Your answer is accepted, David Guetta. Let's talk about another good thing. Back in 2009, you played our yearly concert in Tivoli, Copenhagen, the Voice concert, and now you are playing Tinderbox Festival next year. What do you do to secure that people always get the best David Guetta experience?
I'm just giving everything I have, you know. My performance has always been the absolute priority in my life. That's all I can say, really.
Is it sometimes difficult for you to rethink your show? Now you have visuals, you have fireworks, you have big stage. Is it difficult for you?
Yeah, but in the same way, it's difficult to always come with a new record. Everything is difficult, but that's why we have a career, because we fight hard to always surprise people, always come with something exciting.
David Guetta, we are looking forward to having you back here in Denmark next year, and thank you for your time.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Showet på The Voice med Jakob Mørup. Mandag til fredag fra klokken 14 til 18.